We chose him and his progeny. And I remember mentioning all the prophets after Ibrahim alayhi salatu was salam are from his family. He made that dua. And Allah says, وَآلَ عِمْرَانَ. And he also chose the family of Imran. Who was Imran? The father of Mary, Maryam alayhi salatu was salam, the grandfather, the maternal grandfather of Jesus, may peace be upon him, Isa alayhi salatu was salam. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, look, we also chose him and his progeny. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also choose us to serve this deen and to spread this deen, and to and may he use us to spread the deen, to practice it, to learn it, to teach it, and may he accept it from us, inshallah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then makes mention of a very interesting point. Didn't we mention moments ago that he is the one in total control? So he is also in control of whether he decides to give you children or not, and whether he decides to give you progeny or not, whether he decides to give you fruits that might not be in season. You know, Zakariya alayhi salatu wasalam, he did not have a male child. What happened to him? He watched Maryam alayhi salatu wasalam in the mihrab. She was in the mihrab, in the pulpit. And she used to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala there. Every time she went there, and he went there, every time he went to see her, he noticed she had a plate of fruits and a plate of food, which was not in season. It was out of the season. And he asked, in fact, let me read the verse. كُلَّمَا دَخَلَ عَلَيْهَا زَكَرِيَّا الْمِحْرَابَ وَجَدَ عِنْدَهَا رِزْقًا قَالَ يَا مَرْيَمُ أَنَّا لَكِ هَذَا قَالَتْ هُوَ مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَرْزُقُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. Every time he went, he saw this fruit which was out of season. He told Maryam alayhi salatu wasalam, he asked, where did you get this from? She said, this is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Definitely it is Allah who gives without any account. If he wants, he can provide you with that which is out of season. It's not impossible for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Zakariya alayhi salatu wasalam began to think. He said, I don't have a male child, I don't have progeny. I'm very old, it's not so common for a person my age to have children. But if Maryam alayhi salatu wasalam can have fruit outside season, if I'm a person who does not normally have children at this age of mine, there is a possibility if I also make a dua, it might be answered. So looking at Maryam alayhi salatu wasalam's fruits which were out of season, he too began to make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Allah, don't leave me alone, grant me offspring. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answered him and gave him Yahya, John the Baptist. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us understanding. That was given as a gift to Zakariya alayhi salatu wasalam. So we also never lose hope in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nothing is impossible for Rabbul Izzati wal Jalal. Continue making dua with conviction, and as we said yesterday, remain steadfast. Don't lose hope in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If it is to come, it will come one day. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala open the doors for myself and yourselves. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks of other miracles that he has granted Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. We know that Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, Jesus may peace be upon him, was born through a miraculous way. In a miraculous way, through miraculous means. And even when he was in the cradle, he was speaking to the people. يُكَلِّمُ النَّاسَ فِي الْمَهْدِ وَكَهْلًا. He spoke to people in the cradle, and even at old age, he spoke to people. Amazing, what a miracle. And thereafter Allah makes mention subhanahu wa ta'ala of other miracles which were granted to Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. He was chosen by Allah for those miracles, such as curing the sick, giving life to the dead by the power of Allah, letting a little bit of food suffice for a lot of people. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us barakah in our sustenance. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chooses worshippers of his throughout time, upon whose hands miracles will be manifest. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the ability to strengthen our iman and to believe in the miracles of the prophets and anbiya alayhi salatu wasalam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have mercy on all of us. And Allah says, after mentioning the story of Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, and the reason why it is mentioned here is because the whole surah is named Al Imran, the family of Imran. Who is the family of Imran? Is it not Maryam alayhi salatu wasalam, Isa alayhi salatu wasalam? All of them are the family of Imran. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about them in this surah, and then Allah addresses the people of the book. Why the people of the book? They claim to be lovers of Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. Allah says, Ya ahla al-kitabi, lima takfuruna bi ayati Allahi وأنتم تشهدون. O people of the book, why have you disbelieved in the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Though you are witnesses, you have seen and you can see what is right and wrong. Allah continues in the very next verse saying, لِمَ تَلْبِسُونَ الْحَقَّ بِالْبَاطِلِ وَتَكْتُمُونَ الْحَقَّ وَأَنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ. Why, O people of the book, why do you mix the truth with the falsehood and you hide that which is truth knowingly? May Allah protect us all. Aren't we guilty sometimes of doing that? We know what is right and wrong. We know the truth. We know exactly what is right and wrong, but purposely and intentionally we hide the truth and we make clear or we make manifest the lies. May Allah protect us. If that's the case, we join the ranks of the people of the book who are being admonished here by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah protect us from that. We are Muslimin. We must be truthful. If we are going to lie, what is going to happen to our children? What is going to happen to our offspring? خَيْرُ النَّاسِ قَرْنِي ثُمَّ الَّذِينَ يَلُونَهُمْ ثُمَّ الَّذِينَ يَلُونَهُمْ. The best of generations, the Prophet ﷺ says, is my generation. And then the next, and then the next. Which means each generation generally will be worse off than the previous one, spiritually. Not always the case, but the general trend. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us upliftment so that at least our progeny can still remain on deen. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention of those questions that He has questioned the people of the book with, and the lesson is for all of us. And Allah says, let me inform you that there is only one thing I will accept from all of you. وَمَن يَبْتَغِ غَيْرَ الْإِسْلَامِ دِينًا فَلَن يُقْبَلَ مِنْهُ وَهُوَ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. Anyone who wants to follow a path besides the path of submission to his or her creator, then that path will not be accepted from that person. We must realize this. Islam here refers to submission to the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which means anyone who does not want to obey the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then the other deeds that they engage in will not be accepted by Allah and they will be losers in the akhirah. This verse does not only refer to the deen as the religion of Islam, but it refers to anything that anyone would like to do which is against submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They will be losers. Don't we say Islam means peace and Islam also means submission? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us submitters. We've all said it by tongue, we've declared the shahada, we've read so many times, La ilaha illallah Muhammadun Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We've uttered that so many times, but it's time now that we submit to it and we realize there is a lot to come with it. May Allah grant that to us and make it easy for us. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then speaks about how to achieve righteousness. If you recall, two nights back or last night, we spoke about righteousness. And we spoke about righteousness in detail. Here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in one word, He's telling us how to achieve righteousness. لَن تَنَالُوا الْبِرَّ حَتَّى تُنْفِقُوا مِمَّا تُحِبُّونَ. You will never achieve true righteousness until you spend from that which you love most. A lot of us will probably think that this refers to wealth and things which are material. I open my closet, I look at the suit or the dress that I love the most, and I must spend it in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yes, that is included in this. If our love for material items happens to exceed our love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then by all means that is dangerous love. Spend it in the path of Allah. Give it away, so that we can love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more than anything material. But that is only part of the meaning of this verse. What else do we love a lot? Let me take you deeper into it. We love our time. I want to spend my time the way I want. I love it a lot. I want to go where I want. My time is very valuable. I will do what I want. What about spending that time in the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, coming to the masjid? It requires time. I need to spend what I love most. I want to go somewhere, but Allah is calling. Hayya 'alal falah. Come to success. Then we can't spend there the time that is most beloved to us. That is why we fail. So righteousness will not be achieved until you spend even your time that is so beloved to you in the right cause. With your family members, spend time. How many people, how many wives are complaining, you know, our husbands don't ever spend time with us. Well, you will not achieve righteousness if that is the case. How many children don't even know their parents? May Allah protect us. We need to spend more time with our children. This is what will take us towards